Hey, I'm Matt Reynolds from Barbell Logic, and I'm here with my good friends, William McNeely and Coop from Garage Gym Reviews, and we're gonna show you what's in our gym bag.
The first thing I'd like to share in my gym bag, and I think it's the most important part, is my training notebook. And this just like kind of gives you a good history, you record everything, and I have stuff right now from the past 2 years located in here. I've had these squat shoes for close to a decade now, but
as long as I've known you.
Oh yeah, and just forever. Like, even like the soles have worn out and stuff, but just like I got it replaced 5 years ago from like a shoemaker in town. I got my squat belt, which is 4 inches wide, and then I got my deadlift belt, which is a 3-inch belt. And for me, it fits real well between my ribs and my hips, you know, so it just like, it's actually been really awesome having. I like having a mouthpiece, especially when I'm doing the barbell lifts. It's kind of like having a belt for your neck. Even just giving you something to do like right here, you know, it really sets up your cervical position. So it just like, it really helps you in the barbell lifts. And then I guess the last thing I'd like to highlight for right now, I actually got a squat shirt, which this is called A7, but it just like has grippy stuff. So it like works really well for when you're doing like your barbell squats.
Yeah, it's like a rubberized back on this.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That is my gym bag.
Those of you who've listened to the Barbell Logic podcast know I love e-bags. I actually have 3 or 4 different styles of this exact bag. And the reason I like this is because of all of the things I can fit in it. So as I open this up, you'll see I actually have the same shirt that Will has, the A7 rubber backing shirt. I love this shirt. You can get those on Rogue or A7, that works really well. This is a pair of Rehband neoprene shorts that I have used since 2004. They're covered in strongman tacky. I won my pro card in strongman wearing these. I like wearing these for my hips. It keeps my hips warm, but doesn't provide the same support as say like a squat brief would. This next big pouch, you'll see I also have 2 belts, a 4-inch belt from Dominion Strength. They've made these for me. This is the starting strength belt. They put this beautiful oil on it. 4 inches, heavy duty rivets, a seamless roller. I use this for all my squats and all my presses. And then I also use a 3-inch belt, also from Dominion. This is their suede version. And I use it for all my deadlifts. And again, it's easier to get air in when you deadlift. So I really like that belt. Love Rehband, so I use Rehband. This is R-E-H-B-A-N-D. I use these for my knee sleeves. I replaced my original pair of knee sleeves that I bought in 2001. I replaced them last year, so it lasted me like 17 years. And these are about a year old now, and they've done really, really well. Yeah, the 17-year-old one smelled like a homeless guy, but otherwise, they work perfectly fine. So I use some wrist wraps sometimes, wrist straps. I like these Elite FTS ones because they're rubberized. Here's the thing with wrist straps. They're all way too long. They really just need to wrap around the bar one time and pull. So everybody wants to wrap it and wrap it and wrap it. We'll do a future video on how to use wrist straps. I bring good collars when I travel because I found that most gyms have bad collars. I love these Rogue aluminum clamp collars. They came out with these in the past year. They're not real cheap, but I love the collars. They keep me in my gym bag. Love those. These are my shoes. These are the Adidas Power Perfect 2s. I think they're the greatest squat shoes ever made. Any squat shoes made by Adidas or Nike are fine, but these are the best. The problem is they're not made anymore, so you have to get on Amazon and see if you can find some, or Alibaba or some random black market, whatever. Or these could potentially be for sale for the right price. So Adidas Power Perfect shoes for squats, I really like those. One of the things I love about this bag is I have these secret compartments kind of inside. I use some Elite FTS wrist wraps. Love these for wrist wraps to protect my wrist. I actually have very small wrists and ankles, and so this protects me for heavy bench press and press. I get bicep tendonitis sometimes, and so I'll use these elbow cuffs from How Much You Bench, the slingshot elbow cuffs, to help with bicep tendonitis. Liniment, which is what every old person should have. It's sort of like Bengay on steroids. You lube this thing up, you're on fire for a few hours. So I've got lube up for your body, and then I got lube up for your lungs. These are ammonia capsules. You hit these, you crush them. And so you hit this right before a nice heavy lift. So that's what's in my gym bag.
I am actually a part of the home gym master race. So unlike these guys, I just train at home and I don't need a gym bag. But since he asked me to bring one, this would be what my gym bag is today. It would also change just about every week because I'm always testing something new. But right now I'm using a GORUCK GR1. It's just a standard, you know, backpack, but it's built heavy duty. On the front here, I have a Pioneer cut belt that they made for us. I'm actually testing this one right now. It's a 13 millimeter belt, super thick. I usually use an SBD belt, but this one I'm testing right now. Nice suede inside, nice leather on the outside, lots of rivets, single roller buckle, and just an overall great belt. This, I love this thing. It's super quiet. It works extremely well. My wife doesn't get mad when I use it. It's like a massage gun. Other companies like Theragun, Tim Tam, there's a lot that are out there, but this is my favorite simply because it's quiet. That's the loudest setting, and if you ever use the Theragun, that sounds like nothing.
What is that? What's that called?
This is the Hypervolt Hyperice. Yeah, and they're actually, this is actually surprisingly one of the cheapest one that's on the market. It's like $350. The Theragun is like $700, and this one's better. These are fat grips, so I would probably take these and use these quite a bit. You can throw them on any sort of barbell or dumbbell, any straight bar, including a pull-up bar if you want to increase it. You know, Charles Poliquin, shout out to him. I'm sure you love Charles Poliquin, but
rest
in peace, Charles. But increase hypertrophy, as you can see, I need. These are the Addy Powers. These are basically the upgraded version of the shoes that Matt uses, just like I'm the upgraded version of Matt. So these are a much better shoe. They do cost a little bit more, but you know, I don't cheap out. I get the good stuff. This is a Rogue Supernova ball. Basically, you just mash your body against it. If I was warming up, I'd probably use this a lot if I wasn't using the Hyperice Hypervolt.
Kelly Starrett gave that to you because you guys are best friends.
Yeah, best friend. Me and Kelly Starrett and Tim Ferriss. Yeah, we all hang out. This is, these are from bandlifts.com. So if I'm doing any sort of band work, I'd probably take these. These are a very esoteric device that you don't need, but they're nice to have. You just throw them on the barbell and then attach the bands or change to them. They're pretty small and they just work well, so I like them. This is a hip circle from Mark Bell Slingshot. So if I'm like doing any sort of lower body stuff, I'll put this on and kind of just activate my glutes. I don't even know if that's a real thing.
I have a lot of my women use that actually who have really? Knee valgus as their knees come in.
That's cool.
I haven't do that, so.
Do you have any men like that use them?
No,
because okay. Well,
if your knees come in, you're not a dude.
Yeah,
you're not
that's
a dude.
Cool.
You're a chick.
Appreciate it, okay. And that's about it. So I'm more minimal. Yeah, I don't have to carry a lot of stuff. I'm
we
not
joked.
Like
we joked
band
with you
like him.
Yeah. That we were going to do this video and make Cooper do it in his underwear.
Yeah,
it was
yeah.
just going to come because what he actually lifts in is more like what the Russians lifted in the 70s.
Exactly.
He just shows up to work, takes all his clothes off, gets down to his whitey tighties, and just goes.
That's right, yeah. I don't wear briefs like he does and call them something other than what they are, which is single ply lifting. I just wear what I'm wearing. Yeah, so that's it. That's my gym bag.